This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A harpsichord is a musical instrument played by means of a keyboard. It produces sound by plucking a string when a key is pressed. Harpsichord designates the whole family of similar plucked keyboard instruments, including the smaller virginals, musillar, and spinet. The harpsichord was widely used in Renaissance and Baroque music during the late 18th century. It gradually disappeared from the musical scene with the rise of the piano in the 20th century. It made a resurgence, being used in historically informed performances of older music, in compositions, and in popular culture. Contents: 1 mechanism, 2 strings, tuning, and soundboard, 3 multiple choirs of strings, 4 case, 5 variants, 51 harpsichord, 52 virginals, 53 spinet, 54 clavicithyrium, 55 clavicymbalum, 56 ottavino, 57 other, 58 compass and pitch range, 6 history, 7 music, 71 historical period, 72 music written for the revived instrument, 8 see also, 9 notes, 10 references, 11 external links. Mechanism: detail of the mechanism of the harpsichord by Christian Zell at Museu de la Música de Barcelona. Harpsichords vary in size and shape, but all have the same basic functional arrangement. The player depresses a key that rocks over a pivot in the middle of its length. The other end of the key lifts a jack, a long strip of wood that holds a small plectrum, a wedge-shaped piece of quill, nowadays often plastic, which plucks the string when the player releases the key. The far end returns to its rest position, and the jack falls back. The plectrum, mounted on a tongue that can swivel backwards away from the string, passes the string without plucking it again as the key reaches its rest position. A felt damper atop the jack stops the string's vibrations. These basic principles are explained in detail below. Figure 1, schematic view of a 2x8 feet single manual harpsichord. The key lever is a simple pivot, which rocks on a balance pin that passes through a hole drilled through the keylever. The jack is a thin, rectangular piece of wood that sits upright on the end of the keylever. The jacks are held in place by the registers. These are 2 long strips of wood, the upper movable, the lower fixed, which run in the gap between pin block and belly rail. The registers have rectangular mortises, holes through which the jacks pass as they can move up and down. The registers hold the jacks in the precise location needed to pluck the string. Figure 2, upper part of a jack. In the jack, a plectrum juts out almost horizontally. Normally the plectrum is angled upwards a tiny amount and passes just under the string. Historically, plectra were made of bird quill or leather. Many modern harpsichords have plastic Delrin or Selkon plectra. When the front of the key is pressed, the back of the key rises, the jack is lifted, and the plectrum plucks the string. The vertical motion of the jack is then stopped by the jack rail, also called the upper rail, which is covered with soft felt to muffle the impact. Figure 3, how the harpsichord action works. When the key is released, the jack falls back down under its own weight, and the plectrum passes back under the string. This is made possible by having the plectrum held in a tongue attached with a pivot and a spring to the body of the jack. The bottom surface of the plectrum is cut at a slant, thus when the descending plectrum touches the string from above, the angled lower surface provides enough force to push the tongue backward. When the jack arrives in fully lowered position, the felt damper touches the string, causing the note to see strings, tuning, and soundboard. Soundboard of a harpsichord with Chladni patterns. Detail of the harpsichord by Carl Conrad Fleischer, Hamburg, 1720, in Museu de la Música de Barcelona. A decorative rose descends below the soundboard, in which is it mounted. The soundboard itself is adorned with floral painting around the rose. The bridge is at lower right. Each string is wound around a tuning pin, normally at the end of the string closer to the player. When rotated with a wrench or tuning hammer, the tuning pin adjusts the tension so that the string sounds the correct pitch. Tuning pins are held tightly in holes drilled in the pin block or rest plank, an oblong hardwood plank proceeding from the tuning pin. A string next passes over the nut, a sharp edge that is made of hardwood and is normally attached to the rest plank. The section of the string beyond the nut forms its vibrating length, which is plucked and creates sound at the other end of its vibrating length. The string passes over the bridge, another sharp edge made of hardwood as with the nut. The horizontal position of the string along the bridge is determined by a vertical metal pin inserted into the bridge, against which the string rests. The bridge itself rests on a soundboard, a thin panel of wood usually made of spruce, fir, or, in some Italian harpsichords, cypress. The soundboard efficiently transduces the vibrations of the strings into vibrations in the air. Without a soundboard, the strings would produce only a very feeble sound. A string is attached at its far end by a loop to a hitch pin that secures it to the case. Multiple choirs of strings. While many harpsichords have exactly one string per note, more elaborate separate harpsichords can have more. This provides two advantages: ability to vary volume and ability to vary tonal quality. Volume is increased when the mechanism of the instrument is set up by the player C below so that the press of a single key plucks more than one string. Tonal quality can be varied in two ways. First, different choirs of strings can be designed to have distinct tonal qualities, usually by having one set of strings plucked closer to the nut, which emphasizes the higher harmonics, and produces a nasal sound quality. The mechanism of the instrument permits the player to select one choir or the other. Second, having one key pluck two strings at once changes not just volume but also tonal quality. For instance, when two strings tuned to the same pitch are plucked simultaneously, the note is not just louder but also richer and more complex. A particularly vivid effect is obtained when the strings plucked simultaneously are an octave apart. This is normally heard by the ear not as two pitches but as one. The sound of the higher string is blended with that of the lower one, and the ear hears the lower pitch, enriched in tonal quality by the additional strength in the upper harmonics of the note sounded by the higher string. When describing a harpsichord, it is customary to specify its choirs of strings, often called its disposition. Strings at 8 foot pitch sound at the normal expected pitch, strings at 4 foot pitch sound an octave higher. Harpsichords occasionally include a 16 foot choir 1 octave lower than 8 foot, or a 2 foot choir 2 octaves higher. Quite rare when there are multiple choirs of strings, the player is often able to control which choirs sound. This is usually done by having a set of jacks for each choir, and a mechanism for turning off each set, often by moving the upper register through which the jacks slide sideways a short distance, so that their plectrum miss the strings. In simpler instruments, this is done by manually moving the registers, but as the harpsichord evolved, builders invented levers, knee levers, and pedal mechanisms to make it easier to change registration. Harpsichords with more than one keyboard provide flexibility in selecting which strings play, since each manual can control the plucking of a different set of strings. In addition, such harpsichords often have a mechanism that couples manuals together, so that a single manual plays both sets of strings. The most flexible system is the French shove coupler, in which the lower manual slides forward and backward in the backward position. Dogs attached to the upper surface of the lower manual engage the lower surface of the upper manual's keys depending on choice of keyboard and coupler position. The player can select any of the sets of jacks labeled in figure 4 as A, or B and C, or all three. Figure 4 French shove coupler to the left. Uncoupled keyboards, the depressed upper key lifts the jack A upwards, the depressed lower key lifts jacks B and C to the right. The upper keyboard is coupled to the lower one by pulling the latter. The depressed upper key lifts the jack A upwards, the depressed lower key lifts jacks A, B and C. The English dogleg jack system, also used in Baroque Flanders, does not require a coupler. The jacks labeled A in figure 5 have a dogleg shape that permits either keyboard to play A if the player wishes to play the upper 8 feet from the upper manual only and not from the lower manual. A stop handle disengages the jacks labeled A and engages instead an alternative row of jacks called lute stop, not shown in the figure. Figure 5 dogleg jack, English coupler system. When depressed, the upper key lifts the dogleg jack jack A upwards, the lower key lifts all three jacks A, B, and C. The use of multiple manuals in a harpsichord was not originally provided for the flexibility in choosing which strings would sound, but rather for transposition. For discussion, see History of the Harpsichord. Jan Vermeer's famous painting A Lady Standing at a Virginal shows a characteristic practice of his time, with the instrument mounted on a table and the player standing case. The case holds in position all of the important structural members: pinblock, soundboard, hitchpins, keyboard, and the jack action. It usually includes a solid bottom, and also internal bracing to maintain its form without warping under the tension of the strings. Cases vary greatly in weight and sturdiness. Italian harpsichords are often of light construction. Heavier construction is found in the later Flemish instruments and those derived from them. See History of the Harpsichord. A false inner outer harpsichord from the Deutsches Museum in Munich. The false inner case begins to the right of the keyboard, and continues backward only far enough to provide a slot to support the jack rail. The case also gives the harpsichord its external appearance and protects the instrument. A large harpsichord is, in a sense, a piece of furniture, as it stands alone on legs and may be styled in the manner of other furniture of its place and period. Early Italian instruments, on the other hand, were so light in construction that they were treated rather like a violin, kept for storage in a protective outer case, and played after taking it out of its case and placing it on a table. Such tables were often quite high, until the late 18th century people usually played standing up eventually. Harpsichords came to be built with just a single case, though an intermediate stage also existed, the false inner-outer, which for purely aesthetic reasons was built to look as if the outer case contained an inner one. In the old style, even after harpsichords became self-encased objects, they often were supported by separate stands, and some modern harpsichords have separate legs for improved portability. Many harpsichords have a lid that can be raised, a cover for the keyboard, and a stand for music. Harpsichords have been decorated in a great many different ways, with plain buff paint, e.g. some Flemish instruments, with paper printed with patterns, with leather or velvet coverings, with chinoiserie, or occasionally with highly elaborate painted artwork. Variants. Harpsichord in modern usage. Harpsichord can mean any member of the family of instruments more often, though it specifically denotes a grand piano-shaped instrument with a roughly triangular case accommodating long bass strings at the left and short treble strings at the right. The characteristic profile of such a harpsichord is more elongated than a modern piano, with a sharper curve to the bentside. Virginal's main article. Virginal's. The virginal is a smaller and simpler rectangular form of the harpsichord, having only one string per note. The strings run parallel to the keyboard, which is on the long side of the case. Spinet. Main article. Spinet. A spinet is a harpsichord with the strings set at an angle, usually about 30 degrees to the keyboard. The strings are too close together for the jacks to fit between them. Instead, the strings are arranged in pairs, and the jacks are in the larger gaps between the pairs. The two jacks in each gap face in opposite directions, and each plucks a string adjacent to a gap. The English diarist Samuel Pepys mentions his triangle several times. This was not the percussion instrument that we call triangle today. Rather, it was a name for octave-pitched spinets, which were triangular in shape. Clavicithyrium. Main article. Clavicithyrium. A clavicithyrium is a harpsichord with the soundboard and strings mounted vertically facing the player, the same space-saving principle as an upright piano. In a clavicithyrium, the jacks move horizontally without the assistance of gravity, so that clavicithyrium actions are more complex than those of other harpsichords. An Ottavino built by Arnold Dolmetsch in 1923, and modeled after a 1698 instrument by Joannes Carcassi. Clavicymbalum. Main article. Clavicymbalum. An early relative of the harpsichord, first attested in 1323, with an unusual jack system, and lacking any method to dampen a string once sounded. Ottavino. Ottavini are small spinets or virginals at 4-foot pitch. Harpsichords at octave pitch were more common in the early Renaissance, but lessened in popularity later on. However, the Ottavino remained very popular as a domestic instrument in Italy until the 19th century. In the Low Countries, an Ottavino was commonly paired with an 8-foot virginals, encased in a small cubby under the soundboard of the larger instrument. The Ottavino could be removed and placed on top of the virginal, making in effect a double manual instrument. These are sometimes called mother and child or double virginals. Other. The Arcicembalo, built in the 16th century, had an unusual keyboard layout, designed to accommodate variant tuning systems demanded by compositional practice and theoretical experimentation. More common were instruments with split sharps, also designed to accommodate the tuning systems of the time. The folding harpsichord was an instrument that could be folded up for travel. Pedal harpsichord. Occasionally, harpsichords were built which included another set or sets of strings underneath and operated by pedals which pluck the lowest keys of the harpsichord. Although there are no known extant pedal harpsichords from the 18th century or before, from Adlung 1758, the lower set of usually 8 strings is built like an ordinary harpsichord, but with an extent of 2 octaves only. The jacks are similar, but they will benefit from being arranged back to back, since the 2 octaves take as much space as 4 in an ordinary harpsichord. Prior to 1980, when Keith Hill introduced his design for a pedal harpsichord, most pedal harpsichords were built based on the designs of extant pedal pianos from the 19th century, in which the instrument is as wide as the pedalboard. While these were mostly intended as practice instruments for organists, a few pieces are believed to have been written specifically for the pedal harpsichord. However, the set of pedals can augment the sound from any piece performed on the instrument, as demonstrated on several albums by E. Power. Biggs. Compass and pitch. Range. On the whole, earlier harpsichords have smaller ranges than later ones, although there are many exceptions. The largest harpsichords have a range of just over 5 octaves, and the smallest have under 4 usually. The shortest keyboards were given extended range in the bass with a short octave. The traditional pitch range for a 5-octave instrument is F1, F6, FF3. Tuning pitch is often taken to be a The following chromatic system has been drawn up. Tuning an instrument nowadays usually starts with setting in a. Historically it would commence from a C or an F. Some modern instruments are built with keyboards that can shift sideways, allowing the player to align the mechanism with strings at either a. Media help. The harpsichord was most probably invented in the late Middle Ages by the 16th century. Harpsichord makers in Italy were making lightweight instruments with low string tension. A different approach was taken in the southern Netherlands starting in the late 16th century, notably by the Ruckers family. Their harpsichords used a heavier construction and produced a more powerful and distinctive tone. They included the first harpsichords with two keyboards, used for transposition. The Flemish instruments served as the model for 18th century harpsichord construction. In other nations. In France, the double keyboards were adapted to control different choirs of strings, making a more musically flexible instrument. Instruments from the peak of the French tradition, by makers such as the Blanquet family and Pascal Tascan, are among the most widely admired of all harpsichords, and are frequently used as models for the construction of modern instruments in England. The Kirkman and Schuette firms produced sophisticated harpsichords of great power and sonority. German builders extended the sound repertoire of the instrument by adding 16-foot and 2-foot choirs. These instruments have recently served as models for modern builders. In the late 18th century, the harpsichord was supplanted by the piano and almost disappeared from view for most of the 19th century. An exception was its continued use in opera for accompanying recitative, but the piano sometimes displaced it. Even their 20th century efforts to revive the harpsichord began with instruments that used piano technology, with heavy strings and metal frames starting in the middle of the 20th century. Ideas about harpsichord making underwent a major change, when builders such as Frank Hubbard, William Dowd, and Martin Skoranek sought to re-establish the building traditions of the Baroque period. Harpsichords of this type of historically informed building practice dominate the current scene. Music historical period play media. Bach's Little Prelude in C major being played on a harpsichord. The great bulk of the standard repertoire for the harpsichord was written during its first historical flowering, the Renaissance and Baroque eras. The first music written specifically for solo harpsichord was published around the early 16th century. Composers who wrote solo harpsichord music were numerous during the whole Baroque era in European countries including Italy, Germany, England and France. Solo harpsichord compositions included dance suites, fantasias, and fugues. Among the most famous composers who wrote for the harpsichord were the members of English virginal school of the late Renaissance, notably William Byrd ca. 1540-1623 in France. A great number of highly characteristic solo works were created and compiled into four books of ordres by François Couperin 1668-1733. Domenico Scarlatti 1685-1757 began his career in Italy but wrote most of his solo harpsichord works in Spain. His most famous work is his series of 555 harpsichord sonatas. Perhaps the most celebrated composer who wrote for the harpsichord was J.S. Bach 1685-1750, whose solo works, for instance, the Well-Tempered Clavier and the Goldberg Variations, continue to be performed very widely, often on the piano. Bach was also a pioneer of the harpsichord concerto, both in works designated as such, and in the harpsichord part of his fifth Brandenburg Concerto. Two of the most prominent composers of the classical era, Joseph Haydn 1732-1809 and Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart 1756-1791, wrote harpsichord music for both. The instrument featured in the earlier period of their careers and was abandoned once they had shifted their efforts to the piano. Music written for the revived instrument. Main article, Contemporary Harpsichord through the 19th Century. The harpsichord was almost completely supplanted by the piano in the 20th century. Composers returned to the instrument, as they sought out variation in the sounds available to them under the influence of Arnold Dolmetsch. The harpsichordists Violet Gordon Woodhouse 1872-1951 and in France, Wanda Landowska 1879-1959, were at the forefront of the instrument's Renaissance. Concertos for the instrument were written by Francis Poulenc. The Concert Champêtre, 1927-28, and Manuel de Falla Elliot Carter's Double Concerto is scored for harpsichord, piano and two chamber orchestras. For a detailed account of music composed for the revived harpsichord, see Contemporary Harpsichord. See also Clavichord. Piano notes. Carat Kodak 1987, 19 carat in virtually all instances, more than one means two for the one known three manual instrument. See Hieronymus Albrecht Haas for forged three manual instruments. See Leopoldo Franciolini tiny carat fine full details in Hubbard 1967, p133ff, Russell 1973, p65ff and Kotick 2003 carat AB Hubbard 1967, 19 carat Hubbard 1967, 20 carat Hubbard 1967, various locations carat Deerling 1996, 138 carat Kotick 2003, 61. Carat Marchand, Leslie Alexis 1973 Byron's Letters and Journals, 1816-1817. Press, ISBN 0-674-88845-6. An authoritative survey by a leading builder of how early harpsichords were built and how the harpsichord evolved over time in different national traditions. Kotick, Edward 1987 The Harpsichord Owner's Guide. Chapel Hill, University of North Carolina Press. Kotick, Edward 2003 A History of the Harpsichord, Indiana University Press, ISBN 0-253-34166-3. An extensive survey by a leading contemporary scholar. The New Grove, Early Keyboard Instruments. Macmillan, 1989 ISBN 0-393-02554-3. Material from here is also available online in Grove Music Online. O'Brien, Grant 1990 Rutgers, A Harpsichord and Virginal Building Tradition, Cambridge University Press, ISBN 0-521-36565-1. Covers the innovations of the Rutgers family, the founders of the Flemish tradition. Russell, Raymond 1973 The Harpsichord and Clavichord, An Introductory Study, 2nd ed., London. Historically Authentic Methods of Building. Zuckerman, Wolfgang 1969 The Modern Harpsichord, 20th Century Instruments and Their Makers, New York. University. The Wanda Landowska 16th Century Sculptured Harpsichord. Ferdinand Weber Harpsichord, 1752 Italian II Manual Harpsichord, 1750 History Italian Harpsichord Building in the 16th and 17th Centuries by Shortridge. Listen Hear the Sound of Various Harpsichords. Sala del Cembalo, Free Harpsichord Sound Files. Les Cyclops, 357 Min composed by Jean-Philippe Rameau and performed here by Elaine Comperone. Images Harpsichord Photo, Photographs of Early Stringed Keyboard Instruments. Organizations British Harpsichord Society. Craftsman Insights. Interview with Harpsichord Builder Jack Peters. Interview with Harpsichord Builder Craig Tomlinson. Music scores featuring the harpsichord, scores at the International Music Score Library. Project Prosimbalo. Free catalog of contemporary harpsichord music. Video, Marin Mare, La Sonnerie, Cembalo, Complete 958. Technical about harpsichords. Harpsichord builder Paul Y. Irvin treats the question of necessary and sufficient compass, and other instrument technicalities, in this section of his informative site. VE Musical keyboards and instruments. Most common accordion. Bowed clavier. Carillon Celesta. Clavichord. Digital piano. Electric piano. Electronic keyboard. Hammond organ. Harpsichord organ. Piano spinet. Synthesizer. Virginal layouts. Enharmonic keyboard. Generalized keyboard. Isomorphic keyboard. Janko keyboard. Short octave keys. Frequencies. Pedal keyboard. Split sharp pedals. Expression soft. Sostenuto sustain. Construction acoustics. Innovations wiring. Aliquot cross. Maintenance action. Piano technicians guild. Tuning wrench. Amplifiers, speakers. Keyboard amplifier. Leslie speaker. VE Renaissance music. Movements and schools. Burgundian English madrigals. Franco-Flemish Roman Venetian musical instruments. Bagpipe. Celtic harp. Cittern. Cornet. Harp. Harpsichord. Hornpipe. Hurdy-gurdy. Jaw harp. Kit. Violin. Lute. Mandora. Mandor. Pan. Flute. Pochette. Rebec. Recorder. Reed. Pipe. Sackbut. Sham. Slide. Trumpet. Tambourine. Theorbo. Transverse. Flute. Trumpet. Vihuela. Viol. Violin. Virginals. Musical forms. Carol. Madrigal. Magnificat. Mass. Offertory. Pavane. National and regional traditions. British. Cyprus. Elizabethan. France. Germany. Italy. Netherlands. Poland. Portugal. Spain. Related articles. List of Renaissance composers. Authority. Control. GND. 4009667-1 NDL. 0056297-2.